Hello everyone, and welcome. Hello everyone, and welcome to the 2020 Christmas concert entitled Postcards from Home. Well, originally I was having students sending, you know, me video messages and stuff like that, because their assignment for this concert, the original idea was to have them make video postcards to each and every one of the friends and family that are in attendance today. But because of the craziness of the season, and the hassle, and the bustle, and just all the everything that just helps me not get that happen, we'll get a little distracted. But I'm going to be hoping, let's have this concert actually still be postcards. The postcards from the different composers that you're going to be hearing this evening, from the triumphant and very, very still and beautiful works of James Pernow, to the odd yet kind of twisted but very festive works of Danny Elfman, and so many more different composers that will be featured in today's performance. I hope that you enjoy the performance. Please remember to balance all clothes and enjoy this concert and sit back and relax as we give you Postcards from Home. Having a wonderful
technical difficulties we're working through real quick. Live streaming is fun. It's really great when it works. So give us just a minute. We're working that out so that the folks at home can still hear and see. And we'll be with you with some music in just a minute. working, so we are going to move on to things. First up, we've got Jaron Frenzel. He is one of our percussion students. He's going to come out and play a solo on vibes for us. So please welcome Jaron Frenzel to the stage. All right, I ask them if they're ready, and they say, sure, I guess. So we're going to do this. This is the Junior Varsity Jazz Ensemble. It kind of got started last year, and this year just kind of took off. So I have had a lot of fun working with them so far this year. Really excited to get into festival season next month and start working on some really charts. They're going to really push them, and it's going to be awesome. I love it. We've had some fun with this one, getting ready for some Christmas. We've got Jingle Bells, and then we're going to play God Rest You Merry Gentlemen.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. This group that you see before you is the Concord Hills High School Varsity Jazz Ensemble. That piece that you heard was a rendition by Bob Turner on a familiar tune we all know, Jingle Bells. All right, the next piece that we're going to be playing is near and dear to my heart, kind of grew up with it during the Christmas time period. Introduced me into the world a lot, R&B and funk. This is an arrangement of Donny Hathaway's, and everyone's done an arrangement, the original Donny Hathaway's, This Christmas.
Mr. Riker Smith. Also on my drum set, Mr. Riley Clegg was featured on it as well. And just because I'm a jolly old elf who's been working for thousands and thousands of years, I kind of slipped my mind. The soloist that we had on piano for the Mr. Jingles was Miss Karen Shelton. So let's give a round of applause to her. As you know, at the North Pole, I have many, many different elves. We all know many different things. We have the unfortunate having one special elf who is only here for a short time. I gotta kick him out of the North Pole so he can go do things on his own. Is our very own Mr. Connor Pack. This next piece will be under his direction. So let's give a round of applause to my student teacher and elf, Mr. Connor Pack. Up next is the Copper Hills High School Advanced Percussion Ensemble, and they're going to do an arrangement that I've pulled out from the depths of my archives, an arrangement I did for percussion ensemble based upon the theme that we all know is associated with this time of the year, the Linus and Lucy theme from A Charlie Brown Christmas. So this is my arrangement, my interpretation, if you will, of Linus and Lucy.
is our concert band. We've got a few, you'll see some familiar faces through the night that just kind of keep coming back for more. They just can't decide what instrument they want to play in and what group they want to play in. So this has been kind of a fun group because we've had some of the more seasoned players coming back with new instruments and bringing some of that musicality with some of the scariness of not knowing how to play a new instrument even though they think they should know how to play it. And joining in with some of our younger players and really being able to grow together as a group, and it's been really cool to see. Really want to give a lot of thanks to the parents for all of your help in allowing them to practice at home and making those awful noises sometimes that they have to do. Some programs say that if you were to walk by a practice room and you could recognize what's being played inside the practice room, they're playing it too, they're not playing it right, they're not practicing right. Because practice is such a tedious thing that oftentimes it's not fun to listen to. And I would just want to tell you guys how much I appreciate you for allowing that in your houses and supporting them while they can create music together like this. Our final piece for this group is called Fanfare for Christmas. And see if you can figure out, there are 11 Christmas songs quoted throughout this piece. See if you can find all of them.
Thank you.
Just like I mentioned before, before we kick him out of the nest, if you will, my wonderful elf and helper for this semester, Mr. Carter Pack, was given one last assignment from yours truly to take on this group that you see before, and I told him, here are your things. Program a concert, make them sound really good. And he said, yes, sir. And as I always do, I walked him and any other student teacher I've ever had, I just walked him through the process. So they can understand what it means to have their own classroom one day, which we are very fortunate to know that will happen for him someday. Next up, we'll have Mr. Connor Pack leading the symphonic ensemble. Let's give him a round of applause.
She loved and was loved. Her life was a song of quiet courage. This this piece of music, we've been preparing it for a long time. It's a very, very emotional, very very beautiful piece of music. And as we approach the end of this year, as we approach this concert, we wanted to dedicate this piece of music to everybody who has had to endure the year that was 2020. We had a wonderful, wonderful discussion in rehearsal the other day where a lot of the students kind of opened up about what 2020 has meant to them, what 2020 has felt like to them. And tonight they are going to put all of that into their performance of this piece of music. And I kind of reworded this poem a little bit, and I want to reframe it a bit for what we're doing for tonight. Your life is heroic, but without fanfare. You work and hope and inspire. You love and are loved. Your life is a noble song of quiet courage.
Thank you.
full chamber wind ensemble. The first piece we played was a beautiful arrangement of a composer friend of mine out back, out south, Mr. Charles Boker himself. He and I are really good friends. Small world, his son and I knew each other through passing in school, and when I was connected with him, he was like, oh yeah, you know my son, JV. It's like, oh yeah, I do. So I let him know with rarity that he actually gets his pieces to be played. The next piece we're going to be doing is a compilation of things from A Nightmare Before Christmas. You're like, why does this have to deal with Christmas? Originally, all these other wonderful little elves you see right here that I get to work with every day decided they wanted a spooky Christmas. And I said, we don't do spooky Christmases here in the North Pole. So I made a compromise so I could have good elf production for the rest of the year. And so we're going to play this. But before we do that, one of the things I really want to announce is, and I talked about this at the last concert, about us applying for playing at UMEA for February. And without further moment of view, I just want to let you know, come February 5th, 2021, from 6 to 6:30 p.m., make sure you check out for a link, because your very own Copper Hills Chamber Wind Ensemble is playing at the UMEA conference. So let's give a round of applause. Thank you very, very much. Before we get towards the end, there's something you need to know. Ooh. As you can see, I love that piece.
Don't tell the elves I told you that.
Breath. Something you all need to know, that your beloved children only had so much time to put this together. Myself, Mr. Wicker, Mr. Pack, did the calculations. We only had, at tops, 4 rehearsals to put this whole concert together. So let's give them a round of applause. One of the big things that we told you when we had that shutdown back in November is that you need to come back. Red's technically all hot off the presses, on fire, and you get into the classroom. No ifs, ands, or buts. You need to figure it out. And all on Zoom, they're like, yes, sir. That's a good little elf should. But I just wanted to make sure you all knew that. That was the thing. And I'm just fortunate every day, as well as I know Mr. Whitaker, is to be around these students. But now, there's something that pains me to do this. As I said, there is a certain little elf that must be on his way. But before we do that, Mr. Pack, would you please come out here? We'll recognize him. Ties with me anymore. So, Mr. Peck, if you will, you can open up that present so you can see. Oh, yes. Yes, you know, yes. That's proper now. Any young elf needs to have a light necklace to shine their light upon this earth when they go wherever they go.
Intentionally. That is all.
Let's give a round of applause. Before we wrap up, last thing I want to say, thank you so much to each and every one of you parents, guardians, friends, now extended family. Thank you so much for walking with us through this journey, this crazy journey known as 2020, and allowing us to teach band in whatever shape or form is with us, because I am a firm believer in this. Music is essential in the child's life. It helps with the creativity, but it also helps with them expressing things they may or may not be abnormally wanted to express. Sometimes, when you're in the classroom, you listen to it, kind of hear what they're thinking in their heads, and it's really, really cool. Also, thank you to our administration. Thank you, Mr. Beasy, who I know is the head help here. Thank you very much. Yes. To the rest of the administration, to Mr. Silver and his crew right now doing the live stream, thank you so much. And Mr. Morales on the stage crew, thank you so much for allowing us to. And as tradition, we are going to leave you with something that we always like to do here at the end of the year for our concert for Christmas, is a little Christmas sing-along. You should see the words there that are inside your program. I will give you the cue when you come in. You just watch, I'll turn around, I'll connect in. This is James Bolhar's Christmas sing-along. Why? Why do we do? Kids, remember, there's too many of you, and we're in the middle of a pandemic. That's why we numbered it down. If we had everyone on the stage, all these spread on the entire, we can't do that.